New week, new vendor reset. Yes, Tuesday, guys. Let's see what the vendor sells us, shall we? Are you ready? Let's go! What up, YouTube? Welcome to another Division 2 video. Thanks for clicking my content. Really appreciate you joining me. If you like my content and want to help the channel out, don't forget to smash that like button. And today, Tuesday, new week, new vendor. Let's start with the White House, shall we? Starting with the Zero F's Badger Tough. Of course, the perfectly unbreakable on there. And it has 10% hazard protection, 8.9% critical hit damage, and 90k armor. This could be a decent one, in my opinion, then roll that armor to the max cap. And then maybe with TU-12, roll that critical hit damage to that max cap with our new station. Then the guns aren't that great if you ask me. Only buying them if they have very good rolls. Or yeah, same for the pistols. Not great, you're not using it that much, so just farming it the open world. Backpack, Petrov. Could be nice, tech support on there, 7.3% skill damage, 4.9% critical hit damage, and then 10.9% weapon damage. Could be nice, but in my opinion, too low to buy. Over to the Wyvern, 10.1% skill haste, 16.1% repair skills, and focus on there. And I'm not loving the combination. I would love to see something else for that repair skill, some skill damage, for example, or even some critical hit chance or damage to get it up on our skill crit builds. Over to the mods, 4.5% critical hit chance, 4.6% deflect duration for your drone, 6% duration for your turret, and 4% burn duration for your sticky payload. So let's head over to the clan. And there we are, guys, at the clan vendor. The Night Watcher named Gilligard is for sale here with the 100% scanner pulse haste. I'm not loving this mask because, yeah, the 100% scanner pulse haste isn't that great in the game. But if you like to pick this up, then roll that armor to that max cap because it already has an 8.5% hazard protection. That's pretty decent. Over to the True Patriot mask, 134k armor and 7.9% explosive resistance. Could be nice. Roll the explosive resistance away for whatever you like because the armor is decent. Tip of the Spear mask, 14.8% weapon damage and then 3.6% critical hit chance. In my opinion, definitely pick this up, only 0.2% away from the cap from weapon damage, and you can roll whatever attribute on there. And then when TU-12 drops, just raise that weapon damage a little bit. Over to the Eclipse, just craft it, guys, never buy this. Guns aren't that great if you ask me. These are the rolls that you're looking for, but still, I don't know if you like to have Unwavering on there. And in my opinion, the rolls are too low. Even for the future, to maybe roll it to that God roll, but yeah, that's gonna be expensive. Over to the SOCOM MK20, maxed out health damage, but the rest isn't that great. MP7, same, not great if you ask me. The USC-45, yeah, the guns aren't that great now, guys. And then we got the Providence Vest entrenched on there, and that's a bit of a bummer because it's 12.1% weapon damage, 5.8% headshot, and a maxed out 6% critical hit chance. This could be a very nice vest. It still could be, then roll that talent away, get that entrenched off this vest, and then, for example, improvise this whole vest to that max cap if you like the headshot damage on there as well, next to the critical hit chance, of course. Over to the knee pads from Fenris, could be nice as well. Roll that health away for some critical hit chance or some headshot damage, whatever you think is necessary, and then with the station, roll that weapon damage to that max cap, same for the critical hit damage. Over to the mods, 16.8% repair skills, 5.1% blast radius for your sticky payload, 4.5% duration for your shock traps, and 4.3% burn damage for your turret. So let's head over to the campus. And there we are, guys, at the campus. The long stick is the first thing we can pick up. Perfect Ranger on there, but the rest isn't that great if you ask me. Over to the Surplus SVD, Lucky Shot on there could be nice, but then the rest isn't that great. You could maybe roll the magazine sideways, for example, for some damage you target out of cover, but still, the marksman rifle is too low. Infantry MG5, this is the one that you want. Maybe not exactly this one, but you want to go for an infantry MG5 versus the normal MG5, because this MG can hold 4 attachments and the other one only holds 3. This already has Optimist on there. In my opinion, if you like to pick this up, roll the critical hit chance away from some damage to armor, and then maybe in the future with the optimization table, roll the LMG damage and the damage to target out of cover higher. And then over to the Grupo Mass, guys. 15% weapon damage, 4.6% critical hit chance, and 8.1% critical hit damage. This is a definite buy. Roll the critical hit damage, for example, to that max cap, and you only have to boost that 1.4% critical hit chance if the optimization station drops with TU-12. Pick this up, guys. Bellstone holster, 154k armor, pretty decent, but then the 7.3% hazard protection or the 8.4% status effect on there, I don't know if you like it on there. In my opinion, the hazard protection is too low and I'm not loving status effect on my Bellstone. Over to the mods, 8.2% skill duration, 1 extra ammo for your cam launcher, 7.9% health for your hive, 6.4% cone size for your pulse, and a 5.8% duration for your shock traps. But let's head over to the theater and see what they sell us. And there we are, guys, at the theater. The mop is the first thing we can pick up. Of course, at 10% armor on kill, but this got ignited on there. The shotgun damage is a little bit too low in my opinion, but you can still pick it up if you're looking for it. Then roll the shotgun damage to that max cap, or change the talent if you don't like ignited, and raise the shotgun damage with the optimization station. Military M870, not great. M16, same, too low in rolls. Alps, 10% skill haste and 16.3k health on the gloves. No thanks, I'm not loving the health and the skill haste is too low in my opinion. And then over to the Sokolov. Could be nice, for example, for your PvP build or for your hazard protection build, because this already has 8.2% hazard protection and 10.9% critical hit damage. Then roll that weapon damage to that 15%, and then roll the rest with the optimization station. You have very, very nice Sokolov knee pads. Over to the mods, 8.3% bleed resistance, 4.2% damage for your mine, 1% damage bonus per enemy for your shield, and 5.8% skill haste for your firefly, and of course, always a decoy, and this time a 6% duration. Let's head over to the DZs and see what they sell us. And there we are, guys, DZ East, and again a long stick for sale. Perfect Ranger on there, but you know my opinion, do not buy this at the DZs, especially not if you can buy a better one in the open world vendors. I think this is a bit stupid to put this in this vendor as well. Hunting M44, not great. Black Market RPK, same, not great. Mask from Asus, only 10.8% weapon damage, and you do not want the repair skills on there. Hunter's Fury, 6.2% headshot damage and too low in weapon damage to pick up in my opinion. Badger Tough, 146.4k armor, a little bit of hazard protection and some repair skills, not great if you ask me. Same for the 511, it's not my brand set. If you like this one, this is a decent one with the 5.4% critical hit chance, and then roll the skill haste for whatever you think is necessary. You have a pretty decent 511 holster. And then the mods, you know my opinion, not great, never buy them. Go for the open world fenders or just farm them in the open world. Let's head to the next DZ. And there we are, guys. Second DZ, DZ South, and the Mozambique Special is the first thing we can leave here. Why the hell should I buy a handgun for 152 DZ credits? P90, same. Leave it here. Custom P416 could be a very nice buy. We all know NSYNC is one of the best talents in the game, and then these are the rolls that you want on your gun. In my opinion, roll the assault rifle damage or the health damage to that max cap and boost the rest with the new table coming with TU12. X45, leave it here. Handgun, backpack of tip of the spear, 10.8% weapon damage, 10.1% critical hit damage. Could be nice, a little bit too low in my opinion. If you like to pick it up, roll the weapon damage to that max cap. Eclipse, never buy it, always craft. Backpack from 511, maxed out weapon handling, combined arms, no thank you. Over to the vest from Fenris. Could be a nice one, glass cannon already on there, and then roll, for example, some headshot damage or critical hit chance over the skill haste and boost the rest. But still, the 10.6% weapon damage is a little bit too low to buy this for 102 DZ credits. Same for the mods, guys. Leave him here, do not buy them in the DZs. Let's head over to the next one. And there we are, guys, last DZ, DZ West, and the Baker's Dozen, the named M1A, is for sale here. Perfect lucky shot, of course. And then, if you like to buy this, in my opinion, leave it here. But if you like to buy this, roll that attribute away for some damage to target out of cover. Super 90, no thanks. 6716, maxed out rifle damage, could be nice because it also has damage to armor, optimist on there, and then roll that critical hit damage to that max cap. You have a decent sick 716. Then going over to the future initiative, just craft this, guys, never buy it. Then the striker's battle gear, way too low, and you have weapon handling on there, no thanks. Badger tough, rainbow roll, no thank you. Weapon handling, skill damage, and only around that 100k armor. Knee pads from Sokolov, status effect on there, 11.6% weapon damage, and a little bit too low on critical hit chance. You could boost this in the future, but it's a little bit too expensive to boost, in my opinion. And then, you know the deal, no mods in the DZs, way too expensive. Go for the open world or go for the open world vendors. So let's head over to New York and see what they sell us. And there we are, guys, at the first vendor in New York. Police M4 is the first thing we can pick up. Or yeah, in my opinion, leave here. There's stability on there and spike, not great. Covert SRS, same. ACS-12, not great as well. D50, you could pick it up to craft your Liberty or craft multiple Liberties. But yeah, just leave it here, guys. RNK backpack, 9.9% skill haste and critical hit damage with shock and awe on there. Not a great combo if you ask me. Over to the knee pads from Sokolov. Could be nice with the status effect, but then there is headshot damage on there and the weapon damage a little bit too low. If you like to pick this up, roll that headshot damage away because you do not want to stack into headshot damage with your SMG build. Over to the Sokolov holster. Could be nice with the armor regeneration and the critical hit damage already on there. Then, in my opinion, roll the weapon damage to that max cap. And then with the station coming with TU12, max out the attributes. Over to the mods, 10.1% skill haste, 8.5% skill duration, 4.1% radius for your mine, 6.5% cone size for your pulse, and 4.2% duration for your shock traps. And let's head over to the last vendor of today. And there we are, guys. We are at Roy, the last vendor of New York. Military AKM is the first thing we can leave here. Trash roll, if you ask me. M249, same, not great. 1886, could be nice. These are the rolls that you want on there, or these are the attributes that you want on there. Then roll, for example, the rifle damage to that max cap, and then wait for TU12 to max out the critical hit damage. Magnum, leave here. Pistol, do not buy it, just farm it. Overlord, too low in my opinion, and it has braced over to the knee pads from Kjellgaard. Too low in armor and some repair skills on there. I'm not loving that on my Kjellgaard set. Then over to the Badger Tough. Could be nice mask if you want to go for the explosive resistance, but in my opinion, the armor and the critical hit chance are too low. If you like this, you could buy it and then max it out with the new table with TU12. And then for our last mods, guys, 8.5% bleed resistance, 7.4% headshot damage, 6.4% deflected duration for your drone, 4.9% skill haste for your pulse, and 6% health for your decoy. But yeah, guys, that's pretty much it for this week's vendor reset. Of course, tomorrow, Cassie Mendoza. And today was a little bit different. No face cam because I have a lot of things to think about with my PS5. I need a different setup. But for today, thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed. Don't forget to smash that like button and hit that subscribers button. And of course, the notification bell. Pure Prime out.